Welcome back to the NASCAR 14 Let's Play, ladies and gentlemen. Right now, I'm about to do the season finale, the final race of season 3 of the NASCAR 14 Let's Play. This is the championship race. I'm here at Homestead-Miami Speedway in Homestead, Florida, for the running of the Ford EcoBoost 400. And now, it is time to determine which of the four chase drivers will win the championship. I pulled off a miracle win at Phoenix International Raceway, which got me locked into the championship race here in Homestead-Miami Speedway. After I choked it up at Texas Motor Speedway, I just pulled off the impossible at Phoenix and won there. And so I'm included into the championship race, and I'm going for a championship in this race as well. The other three drivers are Jimmie Johnson, Jeff Gordon, and Kevin Harvick. Will those one of those three drivers win the championship? Will I win the championship? Will I lose it? Who knows? But yeah, we'll see what happens here at this mile and a half Homestead-Miami Speedway. So it's going to be 100% difficulty. Three rounds of qualifying, 80 laps to determine the championship. Tire wear times one, fuel use times two, cautions on, visual damage only, accept the changes. And I'm going to announce this right now. This is going to be the final NASCAR 14 race. There will be no season 4 of NASCAR 14 because NASCAR 14 is done. It's time to move on and focus on NASCAR 15. And then whenever NASCAR 16 comes out, sometime in 2016, focus on that. But this is going to be the final NASCAR 14 race. No season 4, so going to tell you that right now. So I don't want you to ask me, is there going to be a season 4 of NASCAR 14? No, there will not. Maximum I would do is 3 seasons on a NASCAR game. That's it. So after this race, NASCAR 14 is done. It's not going to happen again. It's time to focus on finishing NASCAR 15. Maybe do three seasons of NASCAR 15. And then whenever NASCAR 16 comes out, focus on that. And yeah, so let's get on to qualifying. And I will figure out another NASCAR Let's Play I will do while I'm also doing the NASCAR 15 Let's Play of Season 2. I'm still continuing the NASCAR 5 Truck Series Let's Play. Still need to finish that up. But like I said, for the final time, no more NASCAR 14 Let's Play after this race. So let's just get to qualifying and see what happens. Let's see where I will qualify for this championship race. Qualifying is very important here, so gonna need to qualify well. So here we go. First round of qualifying begins here at Homestead-Miami Speedway. Alright, off turn number 4 to complete the first lap of qualifying, 29.82. So, we have the four chase drivers that's competing for the championship. Me, Jimmie Johnson, Jeff Gordon, and Kevin Harvick. The highest finisher of those four chase drivers wins the championship, if you don't know what I'm talking about. So yeah, so if I finish ahead of the other three chase drivers, if I finish ahead of Jimmie Johnson, Jeff Gordon, and Kevin Harvick, I win the championship. You don't have to win the race to win the championship. You just gotta be one of the four highest chase drivers. Went a little high there. So I have to be in the top 24 to make round 2 qualifying. Right now I am sitting 3rd. Tony Stewart has the fastest lap. Jimmie Johnson sitting fourth. Running this outside lane right now because I feel like that's going to be my line for this race. And it's going to be where I need to pass Cole Whitt too, because Cole Whitt's going to hog that bottom lane. It doesn't look like I'm going to get another fast lap time, so I'm just going to... Alright, looks like I'm going to pass Cole Whitt on the bottom lane. Doesn't look like I'm going to get another fast lap time, so I'm going to focus on race trim. See where I can run. Looks like I could run that outside line. Also, don't have to practice pit lane here. I mean, I don't want to speed on pit road here, but I mean, black flags aren't on, but you know, I don't think I need to practice it. Boy, did I am just riding alongside that wall. Gotta watch out for that safer barrier that pops out. Let me try the bottom lane, see what happens there. Might be tight down there, so let's try it. Alright, more of a middle lane, but whatever. Yeah, it looks like I just go up the racetrack. It's alright. Gotta try out things, you know? Alright, as long as I make the top 24 in this round, I'll make the next round and then hopefully continue my improvement there. Yeah, it looks like the outside lane is going to be my line for this race. Let's try one more time. Yeah, see? Even when, you know, I should just stick to the outside lane. That's going to be my line. Who knows, maybe if I loosen up my car, maybe I could run about... Whoa, did I hit some bump on the track? I had to really get on the brakes because I messed up my line. I hit some bump and my car just went straight up the racetrack, just like that. Boy. Alright, so this will be the last lap of round one. I am sitting fourth as Tony Stewart has the fastest lap so far. Oh, got a little high there. Oh my gosh, look at all these cars leaving pit road here at the same time. Five cars came off pit road. Alright, so session's over. First round is over. Looks like I'm gonna make the second round. Alright, so off to a good start. So now it'll be 3 minutes in round two. Alright, let's go. Alright, so second round of qualifying here at Homestead-Miami Speedway begins. Alright, Logano, you can go, I guess. But... Alright. Jesus, what the hell? Car didn't want to turn at all. I had to keep getting out of the gas. And that's something Logano would do, you know, while we're leaving Pirelli, he would just pass you like that. That's a Logano thing right there. Alright, I know Johnson made the second round. I don't know about Gordon and Harvick yet. Unless I see him out on the track. Alright, so I'm not going to have the fast lap. Oh yeah, I am. 30-48. I am catching Logano though. This lap is going to be better, too. Oh, Gordon did make the second round. I know Johnson did. And what about Harvick? Oh, Logano's taking my line away. Suck a cock, man. Sorry, still going to improve on my lap time here. 30-40. Alright, looks like I need to pass Logano on the bottom lane, because looks like he's going to take up that outside lane. Oh, Casey Kane to the top of the board. As I'm passing Joey Logano right now. Yeah, see, I'm too tight on the bottom. I can't run down there. Alright, as long as I make the final round, which you have to be in the top 12 here. Oh, okay. Just slowed down right there for no reason. Sorry, I got around him now. Looks like I can do one more lap. Those itches. Oh god, okay. Ah, damn it. Well, I'll make the second round anyway. I mean, the final round. I didn't expect the car to go up that high. Wow, Marcus Ambrose is second. Well, it looks like I'm going to be third. That's okay, I got one more round to try to get the pole. So far I'm ahead of the other three chase drivers. Alright. Final round coming up. Let's do this. Final round of qualifying begins. Alright, let's see what lap time I get here. 33.8, that's actually faster than my second round lap. Oh, damn it. Wow, look how close I am to that wall. How did I not touch it? Now, I don't know if Johnson, Gordon, or Harvick made this final round. They were up. Ah, god darn it. Joseph, turn. So far, looking good for me, though. 2/10 ahead of Keselowski. Johnson did make the final round. Okay. Oh, goodness gracious. I am just inching in with centimeters, I should say, next to that wall. Alright, so with a minute left, looks like I'm on top of the board right now. Johnson sitting second, though. Oh, that time I hit the wall. I was riding against that wall last couple laps. Oh, Newman second. Past Johnson. Oh, Marcus Ambrose to the top of the board. What in the world? How about that? Marcus Ambrose could get the pole here. I got one more lap. Oh, shit! I was pushing it too hard, trying to see if I could get a pole lap here. Not gonna happen now. Alright, well, it looks like, unless anybody else passes me on this last lap, looks like I am going to start second. Ahead of Johnson, though. Yep, I qualified second. That's alright. I'm going to be on the front row. Hey, I started second in the championship race in Season 1 of the NASCAR 15 Let's Play, so Oh, man, I should have just checked the overall results. All right, let me check qualifying here. All right, so I'm going to start second. Marcus Ambrose got the pole. Johnson will start fourth. Oh, wow. Jeff Gordon starts 16th, and Kevin Harvick. Wow, Kevin Harvick, 30th. Kevin Harvick, Jeff Gordon, Johnson, and me. I mean, we're all over the place, but there's 80 laps. Long race. Let's get this going. Let's get this championship race started. So, here we go. Here we are at Homestead-Miami Speedway in Homestead, Florida for the championship race and for the running of the Ford EcoBoost 400, the season finale. What the? Did you see Casey Mears? What was that? All right, never mind. Marcus Ambrose starts on the pole. I will start second. Ryan Newman starts third. And Jimmie Johnson starts fourth. My goodness, Casey Mears. I don't know what that was. That was just weird. All right, there's the Ford EcoBoost 400 Wins Trophy if you win here at Homestead-Miami Speedway, but that's not the trophy I'm looking for. I'm looking for the championship trophy. So here we go. The pace car is off. About to get underway. Marcus Ambrose and I will lead the field down to the green flag. And the green flag is in the air. We are underway here at Homestead-Miami Speedway. Off turn number four, Marcus Ambrose is going to lead the first lap as I spun the tires on the start. So, who will be the champion? Will it be me, Jimmie Johnson, Jeff Gordon, or Kevin Harvick? You gotta just be the highest finisher of those top four championship drivers. That's Johnson is in a mess right now. He was just four wide with someone. With the three other drivers, I should say. As I'm catching Marcus Ambrose. I would not be racing for this championship had I not pulled off the win. A miracle win somehow at Phoenix International Raceway. But I am here. All right. Marcus Ambrose is going to take away my line. Marcus Ambrose leads. I'm running second. Jimmie Johnson, who is also racing for a championship, is in third. Jimmie Johnson is in the final, is in the championship race, competing for a championship after he got the win at Texmo Speedway, after I choked it up there. I want to pass Marcus Ambrose on the outside lane. If I try to pass him on the inside lane, I'm going to be tight down there. Here I go for the race lead on Marcus Ambrose on the outside. And I'm going to lead this lap and take the race lead away from Marcus Ambrose. But Marcus Ambrose flying back on the inside. And he's going to slide up in front of me. Me and Marcus Ambrose are actually pulling away from the field right now. Oh, I'm here, Ambrose, here on the outside lane. Boy, did I get a run off turn four. Trying to clear Ambrose. He's still on the inside of me, so I'm leading the way. Marcus Ambrose second, Jimmie Johnson third, Trevor Bayne fourth. Marcus Ambrose not letting me get away easily as I clear him off four. Oh, got a little bit high there. Didn't hit the wall. I'm still going to hold on to the race lead. Now, will cautions come into play in this race? Could change an outcome. Even a pit stop could change an outcome of a race. A mistake. I'm pulling away from Ambrose right now. Got close to that wall. Oh boy. Johnson has fallen back to fourth. Carl Edwards got around him. As I'm pulling away here, this is looking good for me. Oh, wow, okay, car. Like to turn? My goodness. Don't need any mistakes today. This is not the race for it. Although, if I do make a mistake, it better happen early on in the race and not in the final laps. It could cost me a championship. Boy, got very high there. Oh boy, I am just right next to that wall. All right, 10 laps completed here in the season finale championship race here in Homestead-Miami Speedway. Here in Homestead, Florida, in the Ford. Oh my God, I got high again in the Ford EcoBoost 400. I am leading the race, and I am the highest of the Ford Championship drivers, Ford Chase drivers. Marcus Ambrose second, Carl Edwards third, and Jimmie Johnson, who is also competing for the championship, is running in fourth. I don't know where Jeff Gordon and Kevin Harvick are at right now, but shouldn't really matter since I'm not worried about him right now. Jimmie Johnson has the fastest lap of this race so far with a 29.80, minus a 29.83 on lap number 2. And the thing you gotta think about, when will the first pit stop happen? Because when you know when the first pit stop happens, they'll let you know when your next pit stops will happen, like what laps. I'm not pulling away from Ambrose anymore. Just been staying by about half a second, 6, 7 tenths. That's about it. Like I say, you don't have to win the race to win the championship. Just gotta be the highest of the four chase drivers. And right now I am the highest. I mean, I would like to get the win. If I do win this race, it will be my 11th win of Season 3 of the NASCAR 14 Let's Play. Right now, I got 10 wins this season. I couldn't make that 11. I can win the race and the championship. I won the race and the championship in Season 1 of the NASCAR 15 Let's Play. Can I win the race and win the championship here? Aw, damn it, man. I'm telling you, this car is starting to get a little tight. Starting to get just a little tight. But so far, so good for me. As I'm about a second ahead of Marcus Ambrose. Jimmie Johnson is not even in the top four anymore. Martin Truex Jr. has moved up in the top four. Just trying to run the outside lane, because I feel like that's where my best line is at. Even though I got in the wall a couple of times, I feel like this is still my best line. I'm also trying to take it easy right now. Johnson just got... No, well, let me see. No, there's... Johnson's trying to get around Truex, but I think Truex cleared him. I don't have to be too aggressive right now. I'm just trying to take it easy, ride around. No need to push the issue, because if I push the issue, I can make a mistake. And that's something I don't need. So even if Marcus Ambrose catches me a bit, I don't care. Just trying to take it easy. Oh, damn it. Wow, I got close to that wall again. Few drivers are heading down pit road right now. That should be the question right now for me. When am I going to pit? Oh, here comes the rest of the drivers down pit road. I think I should pit next time by two. So it looks like there's going to be a pit stop at least every 20, 22 laps. I could probably stay out for another lap. I want to stay out as long as I can. Alright, I'm going to head down pit road next time by. Or this time by, I should say. So you enter on pit road coming off 4. Alright, here I come, down pit road. 45. Alright, that was a little slow coming in, but that's alright. This car's a little tight, let me fix that. Fix the grill tape, add the fuel. Damage don't really matter, so I'm not worried about that. Just 4 tires, full tank of fuel. Wedge adjustment. Grill tape, I should be back out of the way. Kevin Harvick at me. Alright, so first pit stop of the race right here. Like I said, 4 tires, full tank fuel, wedge, and grill tape adjustment. And I should be back out in the way. I want to be careful leaving pit road here. This could, you know, gotta go on that little road there. I don't want to spin out. So that's slippery down there. Alright, so I'm out in the way. And here comes the rest of the field. Alright, back out in the way, and looks like, Ambrose might be out ahead of me. He came in a couple of laps before me, though, so he had the fresher tires for a couple of laps better than me. But we're side by side, though. Oh boy, did I have to get out of the gas just a little bit. I let him go. There's no point of racing that hard. Alright, I want to run my outside lane. Well, it's not really my outside lane, it's anyone's, but... Well, run my line, I should say. Just run my area. You know what I mean. Kyle Busch has set the new fast lap with a 29.78. Mine's still a 29.83. Where is Jimmie Johnson? Oh, I see him back there. Looks like he's running 7th right now. So I really don't need to be racing out front. I mean, I'm still going to try to lead the way. I don't want to give up the race lead, but I really don't have to be up here right now. So I'm back as the race leader. Marcus Ambrose second. Carl Edwards. And Martin Truex Jr. fourth. Greg Biffle now has the fastest lap so far in this race with a 29.77. As looks like I'm trying to pull away from Marcus Ambrose again. Alright, so far, so good in this race. Most importantly is that I'm the highest chase driver right now. That's the most important part. Looks like Truex got around Edwards for third. So I'm pulling away from Marcus Ambrose right now. By 7/10 right now over him. Feel to spread out just a little bit. Not just a little bit. Ooh, almost hit that safer barrier entering turn 3. Gotta watch out for that safer barrier. It pops out like that. I don't know why it pops out that far. Or it does pop out that far because that's how long the safer barrier is, but I would have put the safer barrier entry down further. I got a little bit high going into turn 1, but didn't hurt me at all. And like, I'm going to take it easy around this racetrack. No need to force the issue. No need to be aggressive. That's why my lap times, as you see, about a second slower. Because I'm not racing too hard, you know? So, things are looking well in this race. Be about 10 laps to reach the halfway point of this race. And now we got 50 laps to go here at Homestead-Miami Speedway. I'm the race leader, Marcus Ambrose second, Martin Truex Jr. third, and Carl Edwards in fourth, as I am the highest chase driver right now, and looking good to win this championship. You know what was funny? When I was reading the comments after that, after I uploaded that Phoenix race, a lot of people were like, oh gosh, wow, oh my goodness, hold on one sec, hold that thought. Alright, so I went way up high going into turn 1. It's alright, I recovered. But after I uploaded that Phoenix race, after I won that race, a lot of those comments were like, is this real life? Or like, whoa, Joseph won Phoenix? How in the hell did this happen? Or is the world coming to an end because I won at Phoenix? It was just amazing what the comments were like. I mean, a lot of you were surprised that I won that race. And after I choked up Texas, I thought it was over for me. I thought I was really gonna have some troubles at Phoenix. But you know what was the miracle part about it is that remember, I was upside down at one point, down the back straightaway, and I restarted in last, and yet I recovered to go from last to winning the race, and won at Phoenix. I mean, that was a miracle. Honestly, after I went upside down at Phoenix, I thought that was it for me. That's going to be my race right there, is me sucking so bad. That's typical at Phoenix, but I had that miracle, you know? You just never give up. And here I am after the win at Phoenix. Here I am racing for a championship. Oh, my God. Oh my gosh. I'm telling you what. I am just having some troubles running up that outside lane in turn one. Turns three and four, I'm fine. But I gotta be careful, because the last couple of times I've hit that wall, my car got sideways after that. Look at Mark Truex Jr. up on the outside of Marcus Ambrose. I kind of held up Ambrose. But look at this. Where is Johnson? Looks like he's getting past again. Maybe I'll run a little lower. So my car is not handling that well right now. Either that or I'm being too aggressive going in the corners. It could be that too. Oh boy. Here comes Marcus Ambrose to the inside of me for the race lead. I should just let him go. There's really no point for me to race him. Side by side down the back straightaway. About a few laps, speed pit stops again. Still side by side for the race lead. About to catch up to someone soon. Still side by side. Looks like I'm gonna clear them off four. So we were side by side for a couple laps, but I got by him. So we're good. Boy, again, I'm up in the wall. All right. This car is handling better, though, than what it did in the first part of the race for the first pit stop. So I'm happy about that. Mark Truex Jr. on the outside of Edwards for third right now. Oh, he's gonna pull up in front of me. I thought so. All right, guess what, guys? This time by, it's going to be the halfway point. Alright, so, here we are, halfway, halfway point here in Homestead-Miami Speedway in the season finale championship race here at Homestead-Miami Speedway, Homestead, Florida, in the round of the Ford EcoBoost 400. Marcus Ambrose is the race leader, I am running second, Carl Edwards third, and Martin Truex Jr. fourth. Greg Biffle has set the fast lap of the race with 29.77, and I am the highest of the Ford chase drivers that are competing for the championship. Here comes Ambrose down pit road. And Edwards. Truex stays out. Out pit within a couple of laps. Alex Bowman, Cole Witt, Michael McDowell, they're out and away. Sorry, McDowell, I didn't mean to do that. And look at these guys on these fresher tires. They're going to be faster than me. Alright, Martin Truex Jr. is down pit road. Alright, I'm thinking about... I'm going to stay out for one more lap and then I'm going to pit. Yeah, I'm pitting next time by. Next time by, I'm pitting. Be on lap 44. Still gonna have to make one more pit stop, though, after this one. Alright, so Casey Kane and Joey Logano, it looks like they're down pit road right now. As I'm gonna head down pit road this time by. Alright, I wanna make sure no one's on the inside of me. Alright, here I come down pit road. Not too fast. Nice entry. All right. All right, I'm going to make my car looser again. Don't need to fix any of the track. You know what? Let me try the track bar some. Let me try that. See if that'll make a difference. All right, so four tires, full tank of fuel, sec pit stop, be back on the way. All right, here we go, back out on the way. Oh, wow. Ambrose and those guys are gonna be out ahead of me. Well, like I said, remember, they pitted. Oh no, those are lap cars there. Oh, so I'm still gonna be out ahead of Ambrose. Okay, I just saw cars coming. I thought, oh, it's gonna be Ambrose, but now here comes Ambrose. It's all right. Like I said, these guys came in a couple laps before me, so they had the fresher tires for a little bit. That's all right. I'm still ahead of the four. I'm still the highest of the four chase cars. Wow, look at this run I got here. Going for the race lead on the bottom. Oh, I hit that apron. Don't do that. Oh, I'm still going to hold off. Yeah, Kyle Busch just moved up to the top four. He's up to third. So, okay, I'm still the highest of the four chase drivers, so I'm okay. If I keep this up, I got this championship. Because look at that. Jimmie Johnson's not even in this pack. So I'm well ahead. So I'm in good shape. I just don't need to make a mistake. Alright, Landon Castle, you're gonna take away my line, huh? And you're gonna slow down in front of me for no reason. Edwards got around Ambrose for second. Looks like Kyle Busch is gonna try to get around Ambrose. As I need to pass these guys on the bottom lane, looks like. Come on, Castle, show some courtesy. Let me go. Alright, it's alright. Got around him. David Gillen is the next car I need to catch and put a lap down. Now, you know what would be a killer right now? If a caution comes out. Would that suck? It's been a caution-free race so far. Getting past David Gillen. Alright, got around him. Alright, so still looking good. Still looking good. No problems. Kyle Busch is there though, challenging me for the race lead. Where did Truex go? He's farther back. All right, 30 laps to go here in Homestead-Miami Speedway. I am the race leader. Kyle Busch second, Marcus Ambrose third, and Carl Edwards in fourth. As Kyle Busch trying to take a peek on the inside of me. So I still don't look like I can hold the race lead. All right, so this track bar adjustment I made, I can tell made a difference. Seems like I can hold the outside lane a little better right now, though. Not on the worn tires. Oh, wow, that was stupid of me. Here comes Kyle Busch to the inside of me for the race lead. Not going to give it to him easily, though. Oh, turn. All right, so far so good. Still want to have the race lead. I mean, it's really no point with me racing Kyle Busch the way I am, but you know, I know I've led the most laps in this race. I've probably led over half the race. It's like Kyle Busch got a stronger car than me on that inside lane than what I'm showing on the outside. It's alright, though. Kyle should not try to squeeze me up on this outside lane either. It's a good bout for the race lead, though. I mean, it's Kyle Busch, I'm not worried about for this championship. Well, I tell you what, it's just me and Kyle Busch up here, too. Because we pulled away from Ambrose and Edwards. And the rest of the field, of course. Oh, man, did I get close to that wall. Whoa, Kyle. Can I clear MR4? Yes. 25 laps to go. I'm not gonna lie to you. I mean, the battle for the race lead has been great and all for most part of this race, but I've had no threat with Jimmie Johnson, Jeff Gordon, or Kevin Harvick this whole entire race, you know? So it's been somewhat boring as well to see who's going to win this championship, you know? I mean, if Johnson was up here and he was challenging me for the race lead, that would have been a different story, been a different outcome in this race, and would have made it interesting, but, you know, it's just Johnson's falling back. I don't know where in the hell Jeff Gordon and Kevin Harvick are at. Jeff Gordon started 16th in this race, and Harvick started 30th. So, it's not been a threat to them this whole entire race. As I'm catching some lap traffic up here. Oh, I didn't get through turn one well. On the entry, I did not, so I had to get on the brakes there. It's alright, though. Still gonna hold on to the race lead. As I need to get by Yaley on the inside lane. I mean, it's just been no threat at all with Jimmie Johnson, Jeff Gordon, and Kevin Harvick. I've just been the dominant car in this race. I mean, I like that. It is boring, don't get me wrong. Oh, wow, I got tight, got up in the Yaley. I mean, yes, it's boring for me as well that I'm not challenging with Johnson or Gordon or Harvick. But it is a good sight for me that I'm not getting challenged by them for this championship. Well, I'm about a second ahead of Kyle Busch. I pulled away. Looks like Kyle Busch trying to get on the inside of Yaley to get by him. Twenty laps to go here in Homestead-Miami Speedway. I'm the race leader and the highest of the four chase drivers. Kyle Busch second, Marcus Ambrose third, and Carl Edwards fourth. I tell you what, Marcus Ambrose has stayed in the top five all race long as well. I've stayed in, I would say, at least the top three most of this race. All race long, I should say. I've not fallen back to fourth or whatever. Final pit stop coming up soon, but Kyle Busch still stays out. I still stay out. Ambrose, Edwards, they still stay out. Still got to make one more pit stop. I do like the handling of this race car. I think that track bar adjustment made the difference. For me. All right. Kyle Busch still stays out right now. Looks like the top five, the whole top five does. 18 laps to go. Here comes Kyle Busch down pit road. Marcus Ambrose, Carl Edwards, Martin Truex Jr. stays out, however. Here comes some more cars leaving pit road right now. All right, Larson and Michael Annette. Oh God, you know what? I'm letting them go. They got fresher tires. They're gonna be faster than me. That was not a smart move on my part. Here comes Martin Truex Jr. He's heading down pit road. When do I pit? Is the question right now. I'm gonna pit this time by, why not? Kurt Busch, Dale Earnhardt Jr. is out and away. All right, I'm pitting this lap. All right, here I come down pit road. Oh, slid it in there. Wow, all right, I'm good. Wow, that could have been big. Let's do this one more time. All right, add the fuel, yes. All right, four tires. Because my car is still a little bit tight. I want to make it perfect. All right, so here we go, the final pit stop of the race, the final pit stop of the NASCAR 14 Let's Play. Here we go. This is the money stop. Alright, go, 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 go. And I'm back out in the way. Alright, here comes Kyle Busch. Alright, so I'm back out in the way, and it looks like Kyle Busch is probably going to get around me here. Yes, he is. That's alright, though. I'm still going to be the highest of the four championship drivers. 15 laps to go, by the way. Be 14 to go right here. If a caution comes out, that's going to be a killer. That's going to be bad. Anything could happen these final 14 laps, so it's not over till it's over. I'm still going to challenge for the race win, why not? I want to win this race and win the championship at the same time. Guys, I'm sorry if this race has been boring to you, just based on that I've had no threat with Jimmie Johnson, Jeff Gordon, and Kevin Harvick. The only positive thing about this race, well, for me, it's that I am ahead of the four. I am the highest of those of the four competitors that are going for this championship. But I mean, another good thing is that there's been battles for the lead and stuff. So it's not like I really dominated by staying out front. So yeah, but it is what it is, I guess. In season one of the NASCAR 15 Let's Play, it was me and Carl Edwards, which he's sitting in third right now. It was him and I battling for the championship. Alright, Danica, you're gonna slow up in front of me, huh? It was me and Carl Edwards battling for the championship in that 27 lap race. So you're gonna have some good battles for the championship, and you're gonna have some not so good battles for the championship. I gotta get around Danica. As I do get around her, got around her easily too. And I'm gonna be back on this outside lane. So I apologize if this race is boring to you. I'm just doing my job, and that's to win the championship. Granted, in a video game, of course, but I'm just doing my job, and that's to win a championship. 10 laps to go here in the Ford EcoBoost 400 here at Homestead-Miami Speedway in Homestead, Florida at the Mile and a Half Speedway for the season finale and the championship race. I am leading the race right now. Kyle Busch, Carl Edwards 3rd, and Marcus Ambrose 4th. I am the highest of the four chase drivers. Jimmie Johnson, Jeff Gordon, and Kevin Harvick are also competing for a championship, but however, they have been no threat at all in this entire race. I've been the dominant of these of the four drivers that are competing for this championship. What would be a killer right now is if a caution comes out, or if I make some stupid mistake, if I wreck right now, it's over. Gotta be extra careful. But like I said, I apologize if this race was boring to you. It's not my fault, okay? I'm just doing my job, and that's to win the championship. 8 laps to go. If I also win this race, it'll be my 11th win of the season. I am half a second ahead of Kyle Busch right now. Still trying to get around some lap traffic. Looks like I'm catching Paul Menard right now. I'm gonna lap him soon. Down the back straightaway once again. About almost a second ahead of Kyle Busch. Remember in season one, and I'm gonna go way back to season one of the NASCAR 14 Let's Play, where not only I won the race, but I also won the championship in season one of the NASCAR 14 Let's Play. And then fortunately, I never finished up season 2, I just went on to season 3. Because I remember that I got so far behind. I mean, I could continue on with season 2, but I thought it was proper for me to start another season of NASCAR 14 and just move on to season 3 and not finish season 2. 5 laps to go here in the season finale as I need to try to get around Menard. Can I hold on for 5 more laps and not only win the race, but win the championship? Got around Paul Menard to lap him. Looks like Paul Menard's gonna not make it easy on me here. 4 laps to go. About a second ahead of Kyle Busch right now. Almost. Ooh, got a little high there. It's alright though. It's alright. We're good. 3 laps to go. When I made it into the third in the eliminator round at for to compete to see if I could get the win, I thought I knew my best shot, my worst shot was going to be at Martinsville Speedway, and then at Texas Motor Speedway as we're coming to 2 laps to go at Texas Motor Speedway, where I was the dominant car in that race. Thought I could have had the race won at Texas, could have locked myself already for this championship race, but I choked it away coming to 2 laps to go, going into turn number 3, when I got a little high going into turn number 3, got into the outside wall, and Jimmie Johnson went on by me, and Jimmie Johnson won the race, which got him to make the final four to win the to be in the championship race. And now white flag is out, final lap here Homestead Miami Speedway and for the championship. Can I hold on for 1 more lap? And then I went on to Phoenix International Raceway, where I thought where it was going to be my detriment race to try to see if I can lock myself into the final four. Down the back straightaway for the final time, going to turn number 3, After I pulled off a miracle win at Phoenix International Raceway, here I am competing for the championship. And now coming off turn number four, not only am I going to win the race, but in three wide fashion, not only I win the race, but I also win the championship. I win the Ford EcoBoost 400 here at Homestead-Miami Speedway and wrap up the championship in season three of the NASCAR 14 Let's Play. Nice. And also got my 11th win of the season. All right. If it wasn't for that win at Phoenix International Raceway, I would have not been competing for the championship. I had to win Phoenix. If I did not win Phoenix, I would have been one of those drivers that are just looking for another win and not for a championship. I'm still mad at myself that I choked a win away at Texas Motor Speedway, but then that miracle win at Phoenix International Raceway made it up. Nice, nice, nice. Look at the scrapes on this side of the car. On the right side of the car. Oh yeah, look at these burnouts right here. Nice burnouts. Nice, nice burnouts. All right. Oh, yes. Yes, yes, yes. And here I am in victory lane. After I won the Ford EcoBoost 400. Got my 11th win of the season. Nice. Oh, I know it was a boring race because there was literally no championship battle. No threat with Jimmie Johnson, Jeff Gordon, and Kevin Harvick. I know that. I mean, it was a good race for me because I didn't have any threat. But, I mean, yes, it was boring. I'm going to be honest, you know. I mean, it wasn't boring battling for the race lead because there was quite several battles for the race lead. All right, so before we move on, let's check out the finishing results here. So, look at that. I led 72 of the 8 laps. I didn't lead the other eight laps. So I win the Ford EcoBoost 400 here at Homestead-Miami Speedway, which locked me up the championship. Kyle Busch second, Carl Edwards third, Martin Truex Jr. fourth, Marcus Ambrose finishes fifth, Eric Almirola sixth, Matt Kenseth seventh, Austin Dillon eighth, Jimmie Johnson, who was another driver that was racing for a championship, finishes ninth, and Ryan Newman rounds up the top 10. Jamie McMurray, 11th. Trevor Bain, 12th. Greg Biffle, 13th. He set the fast lap of the race with a 29.77. Brad Keselowski, 14th. Ricky Stenhouse, 15th. Casey Kane, 16th. Kurt Busch, 19th. And Denny Hamlin rounds up the top 20. 21st, Jeff Gordon. He was another driver that was going to compete for a championship, but I saw him. I did not see Jeff Gordon at all that whole entire race. Dale Knight Jr., 22nd. Joey Logano, 23rd. Kevin Harvick, the other driver, the last driver that was racing for a championship, I did not see him at all in this race either. He finishes 24th, so he wasn't up there to race for a championship either. Tony Stewart, 25th, Clint Bowyer, 26th, and rounding up top 30 is Ryan Truex. 31st is Alex Bowman, 32nd is Michael McDowell, 35th is Danica Patrick, and rounding up the top 40 is Parker Kligerman. 41st is Landon Castle, 42nd is Michael Annette, and finishing 43rd in last place is AJ Allmendinger. I don't know how he finished back there, but he did. Alright, so let's continue. Alright, and I'm going to see the championship stage and me on that stage. Alright, I'll take it. I'll take a championship. Alright, yep, here I am. Season 3 NASCAR 14 champion. Got, I believe that's Kim Kuhn. Miss Sprint Cup. And yes, I have held up the Sprint Cup trophy. Nice. Alright. Alright. So, NASCAR 14 Season 3 is in the books. Now, like I said at the beginning of this video, no more NASCAR 14 Let's Play. NASCAR 14 is done. Not going to do a season 4. Just going to move on. Finish up NASCAR 15. Going to start another NASCAR Let's Play. And whenever NASCAR 16 comes out, going to do that as well. So, yep. Look at that. By 8 points over Jimmie Johnson, I win the championship. Total of 11 wins, 7 poles, 21 top 10s. Jimmie Johnson finishes second in points. Jeff Gordon third in points. And Kevin Harvick fourth. Then you got Kyle Busch, Casey Kane, Carl Edwards, Brian Vickers, Matt Kenseth, and Dale Earnhardt Jr. in the top 10. And then the rest of the point standings. So, that's it. How many winners? How many different winners do we have? 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8. Then you got Matt Kenseth, who is the highest with no wins, in 9th. Let's see, 9, 10, 11, 12, 13, 14, 15... 16, 17, 18, 19. Looks like we had 19 different winners. 19 different winners out of the 36 races, so that's half the season. Alright, so this Let's Play, NASCAR 14 Let's Play, is over. I win the championship. Congrats to myself. And hope you enjoy the season 3 of the NASCAR 14 Let's Play on a scale from 1 to 10. What did you think of it? And yeah. So that's it. Hope you enjoy. I know it wasn't a real battle for the championship, honestly, because like I said, Jimmie Johnson, Jeff Gordon, Kevin Harvick was no threat. But it was a championship for me, and I'm happy about that. It was, and I would have not had that championship if it wasn't for that Phoenix win, which was a miracle. All right, so anyway, hope you enjoyed the NASCAR 14 Let's Play. It's now time to continue on with NASCAR 15 Let's Play, finish up the NASCAR 5 Truck Series Let's Play, and then start another NASCAR Let's Play. So I will see you later. I'm Joseph Lombard, a.k.a. Interesting 4. Have a good day, and I'll see you later.